broadcast network, AfterBuzz TV. Over 20 million weekly downloads in over 150 countries and your number one source for after-show entertainment. Very good, TV, the destination for TV superfans, producing aftershows for over 300 of your favorite TV shows, interviewing celebrities and showrunners, and bringing you behind-the-scenes exclusives. All thanks to E! Entertainment's Maria Menounos, producer Kevin Undergaro, and internet leader Akamai. Now, let the buzz begin!
The theme that we like. We always like, we'll keep this one. I mean, we like this one. Brings back in time. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the GH Report.
Yay!
We're back. I'm back. This is the GH Report, the General Hospital After Show here on AfterBuzz TV, where we talk about all things Port Charles on camera and off. I am one of your hosts, James Lott Jr., and of course you can find me on the interwebs under Black Hope LA on Twitter, L Black Hope on Instagram, which I'm waiting, and James Lott Jr. on Facebook. Where can you find me? Just type in James Lott Jr. and find me. But I'm not alone, of course, and they did such a great job when I was not here last week. Frank did a great job in the hot seats.
James gave me a lot of notes afterwards. Yeah.
I was like, okay, come on.
Let's break it down, Frank.
You should have laughed a lot more. To represent me, of course. No kidding. But they are starting with Mr. Frank over there.
Frank Moran. You can find me on Twitter at HappyGoJackie. That's with an IE.
Hi, guys. My name is Ladine Harvey. You can find me on Twitter at Ladine_Harvey.
And I'm Lacretia Lyon, and trust me, there's only one. As long as you spell it right, it is LacretiaLyon.
That's right. That's right. There's only one. And thank God, because you're unique, and it's you. That's right. Yep. So we're here to talk about, of course, everything that's gone on. And, of course, you can also follow us by using the hashtag ABTVGHReport, or just GH Report, or GH Report, GH Report, whatever you want to use. Just include the GH Report parts. On Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. Also, you can follow us on Audition Days. So I did my wrong show already.
James.
You got it. I've been a little rusty.
Your favorite is James. We got it.
It's my first day back in like 2 weeks. 2 weeks, kids. 2 weeks. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, even got sound effects.
Thank you, Zach. That's just so crazy. GH Reports is what I was going to say. And also, I want to tell you guys, thank you so much, because we are almost up to 400 likes on our page, and we just started out. So that's really great. So please tell all your friends, anybody who likes GH, and on YouTube and on iTunes, find us and tweet us and like us and comment, everything. We appreciate it very much.
Yes, we do.
So this week was a very fast-paced week.
Yes, it was.
I was thinking about you, because the week before wasn't so fast. Mm-mm. This week, I was like, Wednesday, I was like...
They're wasting no time.
No, a million things. It was like, drop the bomb here, drop the bomb right, there,
like,
drop the bomb there.
This week was the first week of the writer. You know how everything
Exactly. Yeah. It went really fast. And the writing is really kicking in. Mm-hmm. That new writing. It's like, okay, well, we're just, like, we're not wasting any time at all. So I thought it was really great. And we're going to start out with Olivia, Ned, Julian, Alexis, and baby Leo, who is in real life, Lisa Lucicero, who plays Olivia, is her actual baby.
Oh, yes. Oh, wow. He's so cute.
He's so cute. It's actually her actual real life baby playing baby Leo.
Yeah, it's just like Georgie is Max's
yes,
real
exactly.
life baby and
yes.
Kristen Storm.
So. Yes, exactly. Mm-hmm. So it was kind of funny to see Ned back. Wally Kurth. Mm-hmm.
What a tease. What a tease.
He was just so patient. Oh. It's like he comes back just to break up with Olivia for 5 seconds.
Right.
I was so mad.
I really thought they were going to be able to mend things. And I'm like, you should have never let him went first in the conversation. You know what I mean? Absolutely love him.
I mean, it just felt like it reached a point with that storyline, because we know what Wally Kurth's on Days. But that storyline was left in such a place that you needed to have some sort of kind of resolution, since you can't keep him on the show. You just needed to end it. And I feel like, I mean, they had to do the best they could in that situation. It really wasn't a great way to exit, but what could they do?
Yeah. Right. I agree. I think it was nice of NBC and ABC to work that out, first of all. Thank you guys for working that out, because as fans, that was great for us. And Wally Kurth, of course, loves playing Ned. And we got a little bit of stories with Brooklyn, you know, as he's touring. And his reasoning actually wasn't that bad. I mean, it was just kind of like, yeah, I can't do a lie.
Yeah, and I think it was like, if he was ever able to come back full time, I think they would get back together. I mean, it wasn't like a breakup, like, I hate you. It was just, I can't live with the lie. And now that the lie isn't there.
I mean, technically, yeah. After this week is over, he pretty much can come back because the lie is no longer there anymore. Yep. So it's like, come on.
That is kind of true, right? That is kind of true. But we know he's on days. And for a while, he was doing both. But on days, he's actually on contract. Mm. So when you're on contract, you can't do both.
And I feel like he's, story-wise, he's got to say that he's not fine with lying, only because he's not on the show anymore. If he were still on the show, he'd already agreed to do this lie. In fact, he said that. He's like, I'll say that I'm the father of this baby. So he was on board with the lie right from the get-go. It's only because he's no longer be able to be on the show that I felt like they had to just switch his thinking on.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, and the thing is, I mean, it's not like this was his first time. I mean, he did the same thing with Alexis. And I like that she brought that up, that she was actually understanding with Olivia.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. And I was glad she was, too, because it would have been hypocritical of her. We'd go, what are you doing? It's like, wait a minute, you didn't want Christina to know Sonny. That was a whole thing.
Yeah.
And they're, you know, okay, in real life, because Frank and I both are parents, I think in real life, you want to protect your kids. So I get the reasoning.
Mm-hmm.
It's not. I'm not saying it's right, maybe, because I mean it's a parent. I mean it's whatever. But I kind of get that you want to protect your kids from the mob, obviously.
Well, and to me,
that's true. I'm fooling around with so many mobsters in my time.
Yeah. I know. Yeah. You know how it is.
It's just dangerous. Yeah. I mean, and the thing is with Olivia's age, and it was one time. I mean, you could kind of see. It's like, yes, you know, she does have a kid with Sonny, but he was a teenager, and with Julian, it was like a one-time thing. So it's not like she's a woman making a string of bad decisions.
Right.
She just got herself in the same spot she was when she was 16. And you're like, you kind of felt bad for her and understood. But now that Julian's out of the mob and was so understanding, I was like, what?
But now here's the thing. I see chemistry between Olivia and Julian.
Oh, I do too. I think she's going to give Alexis a run for her money.
I did. I saw when they got together. Remember, they hate each other. And it was kind of hate sex. And because their others were together. And I kind of see a little chemistry, actually.
That might have went right over my head because I didn't see any of that.
So you don't see it.
I don't see it. I think he's happy with Alexis.
Oh, no, I think he is too, but I see little pings of stuff.
You think that now that they may come to an agreement with parenting that they might end up back together?
It's a soap opera, right?
Yeah, I mean, they've got to do something to shake up Alexis and Julian now that, he's shown he's officially out of the mob, that all that secretiveness was our new, brand new house.
Because we all know that it's not going to be peachy creamy.
Well, I thought of you, Lacretia, when he was mostly naked from the top up as he found out he had a son. I never learned how I had kids while I'm like, you waist up with no shirt on. And what are you talking about? Oh my God. I was like, it's flexing. Oh my God, his little shirt on.
Julian never has a shirt on.
He doesn't.
He's like Nathan. Like, when they have clothes on, you're like, what's going on?
Yeah.
Well, it started off great because they're outside the house that he builds for her. And the best line when he says, Alexis, building you this house was both an honor and a pleasure. And then they go up to the bathroom and they got the great old hot tub.
Yeah.
And then they make the move. And I love Julian's move is he goes right for the butt and he squeezes the cheek. Right for that move. Look
I
at
was
you.
Like, hold on. Did they let him do that? Was that an actor choice?
God,
I was like, whoa, what's going on here? That's a little bit much for me.
Alexis is known to be a frisky lady. I remember she was the one that told Sean to go and make her a sandwich after. I was like, all right, girl.
Yeah, okay, that's right.
So Alexis, she gets down and dirty.
Yeah, you there.
Is it me or, like, when he was constantly on the phone saying, get it done, get it done, For some reason, I thought maybe he was trying to order like a test for the baby or something like that. I would have never thought
A house. I didn't think a house either.
A house?
I almost forgot she'd have a house.
You know what I mean? Like I don't know.
Because they're all living in Jason's old house. I thought
him and Alexis was trying to do the same thing. Maybe that's I don't know. I never thought a house though.
But they get the reveal was fast. It wasn't like they didn't drag on for weeks.
It was like,
let me show you what's going on, and that's it.
I like that.
So that's kind of cool. And also the scenes were longer with Olivia and him and her holding that baby. She was like, okay, you're not doing this baby. But it was really interesting scenes going back and forth because he was kind of right about stuff. She was lying.
Yeah.
It was like, this is my child. You lie. I want my baby. I totally get it. It was funny hearing it from a male perspective because usually it's the females like, I want my baby, like Ava. And I want my baby.
Yeah.
It's funny hearing it from a guy.
Yeah, but at least I liked about it that, well, one, I liked the scene with Alexis and Julian, where, as you were mentioning, that Alexis was explaining, like, she's been in that similar position and can relate to Olivia, and just not to tell Julian not to fly off the handle.
Yeah.
But then, of course, as soon as she leaves, you know that's what he's going to do.
Yes,
I mean,
it's
like, all right, way to wait it out, Julian. But then I also just like that they just, after a little heated blow up first, they approach it like rational adults, and they could both see each other's reasonings for why they were feeling the way they were.
Well, I'm seeing in the chat room a bunch of, it's about half and half. There are people who are saying they see Liv and others are like, no. So what do you see in there?
Oh, I don't think I can repeat this on the air. The last one, Alexis chose the junk over her kids. I love that comment, and I have to agree. I mean,
yes, because Molly is not that far off in her feelings. There were a lot of folks I saw online who didn't like the way Molly was talking to her. To Alexis, I guess.
But
I kind of see where Molly's coming from.
Right.
Yeah, Molly has a right to feel the way she does because he framed her dad.
Yes.
And, you know, so sorry. I mean, Molly is 18. I mean, and it's not like she's really living off mommy anymore.
No.
She got her own thing.
Yeah. So, I mean, I don't know. I kind of see it, but the disrespect for the mother, I guess, is all. But Molly's always been that way, kind of. She's always been kind of the yelling back at her mother. Because Christina wasn't that bad towards her like that, and neither was, Sam did other stuff, of course, but.
I kind of wanted to, like, backtrack for, like, 0.2 seconds.
Yeah.
You know the situation when Julian went to approach Olivia after Alexis told him no?
Mm-hmm.
That kind of reminded me of when Sam and Spinelli was researching whatever, and then Jake went over to
Nicholas.
I don't know if I kind of liked the way they were going with that, like, after we said no and then you still
went.
Well,
they're men.
Yeah.
It was like,
men don't listen. Do we listen?
Like,
we'll
the writing
listen.
Of that. We'll it was kind of like,
we'll
I was thrown
I
off just a little bit.
It's testosterone. I'm going to do whatever I want.
No one on soap operas ever listens.
Yeah.
It felt like when Jake came back, though, and talked to Sam, it felt like it wasn't much of a surprise that he went over to Nicholas, because it seemed like it was just to ruffle some feathers and see what Nicholas was going to do. So I felt like there was some sort of, well, we didn't see it on camera, some kind of understanding that that Jake was going to go over and do that.
Yeah. You guys are all four of us are kind of mirroring what's
like
going on.
Yeah. Like the little details.
Yeah. No, I love it. No, but they're all kind of mirroring what we're saying in here. Like some are like, we love her, we hate her.
Mm.
People and a lot of people say like Haley Poulos, who plays Molly. She's a great actress.
Yeah, she's amazing.
She's an amazing actress. Of course, where's Christina?
Yeah, like Lexi Ainsworth, is she with the cast? Because she showed up at the wedding. She showed up at Sonny's bedside. But where is Christina? You know,
I think
she has an opinion on Julian and Alexis and what's going on, especially now that they've got baby Leo in the mix. And, you know, where's Christina?
Where's Christina?
We need to have the little missing posters.
Yes, I know, really, totally. But I will say, I'm it's going to be interesting to see. I think a triangle is brewing, obviously.
Yeah.
And baby Leo will be the center of it at some point. Will there be a custody battle? I don't know. Because there'll be too many. We already have the Ava thing about to happen. I mean, would there be two of them? I don't think so.
I think at their conversation, it kind of really put that at ease, at least for now. Because Olivia and Julian really did have a heart-to-heart. He calmed down and, you know, she was like, you know. Okay.
Yeah. If anybody if you guys out there heard anything about Lexi Ainsworth, because I haven't seen any news, like, is she still on the show? Like, is she reoccurring? Is she still, what's going on? Let me know and I'll take a look. So that's that storyline. So it was nice to see Wally Kurt. Thank you for coming back for a minute. The next one is, and this actually is kind of I kind of like this storyline right now because it's so crazy. Spinelli, Sam, Jake, Elizabeth. God, Becky Hurst, who plays Elizabeth, she is working it out. I mean, they are putting her through the ringer.
And I'm
so glad.
It's like, finally, Elizabeth is interesting. I mean, I'm not rooting for you.
Right.
But I'm actually intrigued by your storyline. You're not just the nurse, the side beast, whatever. Like, you've been for years. Now you've actually got some interesting story.
Yes.
Well, I just like for her little surprise, little shower there, wedding. I just mentioned, like, all right, just in a few weeks, it's just going to be, you're going to walk into a room like that and everybody's just going to hate you.
I know. And they brought back Epiphany, my girl. they brought the black folks back. It was like Felix, Epiphany, they're all back.
Yes, I love
But no, I was happy to see them because they are friends. Epiphany's friends with her and stuff. And it was kind of fun. Like, I wonder what they're going to think when it comes out.
Oh, yeah.
This reveal is going to be crazy talk.
Well, and I love when she asked Patrick. Patrick to stand up for her. I was just like, oh, this is going to be bad. Like, you, and he is going to hate you. That, I mean, now he's going to have no one.
Because like, I'm just imagining, like, within the context of the show, if you just knew, like, one of your really close friends that you've been working with for years and you've known for years, I mean, she's had her rough parts, but it didn't seem like that's behind her. But then all of a sudden you find her for the past year, she's been lying about knowing that this guy has been alive. God.
For me, I'm just so ready for this reveal to be over with.
It's coming November 6th. It's coming.
Oh, my God.
It's coming. Girl, it's coming. It's coming in 2 weeks. It's coming.
It's like I'm with her now. Like, I'm just tired of seeing Elizabeth and her little, I can't do it. I can't do
Let's make love right now so you stop looking for yourself. They make love. Like, okay. She's like, stop looking for yourself. You're with me now. They like, make love. It's like,
oh, God.
Okay. I mean, okay.
It was hot on GH this week.
Oh, yeah. A lot of people do all kind of stuff. No. Yeah, kind of
sex everywhere, right?
Yeah. Someone writes in there, oh, Kendra John, Rebecca Hurst has flawless skin. She does look good. Yeah. She looks great. I mean, she does look great. But yeah, I really think with Jake and Sam, that part, I love them working. I'm actually rooting for them. Even though I know he's Jason, but I'm like, I like the character. I keep saying this every time. I like the character of Jake.
Yeah, I mean, he's certainly, unlike Jason, he seems a little bit more hair triggered.
Yeah.
A little short, you know, that things that really push his buttons really get a rise out of him.
But I think these little traits of Jason starting to come out of Jake, though. Like, and I think Sam is noticing those little bit of things that he do. Like his anger outbursts and things like that. She's like, oh my God.
Yeah, that's what I love. And Kelly's doing such a good job at it. With Sam just sitting there, like every time he does something that reminds her of Jason, you see that on her face. Like, God, he just reminds me of him. And I think that's why they keep getting drawn together. And but yeah, I mean, when you think he's dead, so she's obviously not putting that together yet.
Well, I'll tell you, again, going fast. They're finally getting wise. With Spinelli, of course, being back, we love Spinelli. Bradford Anderson, you just, you're a savior. I'm a huge...
He's like the best sidekick.
I'm a huge fan of his and his work. That he's back, but they're figuring it out, piecing together with the brain scan. So I'm like, hello, there we go.
Absolutely, yeah. I'm looking to see forward. I'm hoping that he has a major part in the revelation. That would be really cool to see him piece that all together.
Yes, because, well, of course, he got arrested at the end on Friday. So,
and but, I he, but he wiped Diane's his hard drive.
But he wiped his... Oh, sorry?
Diane's back.
And Diane's coming back. Yeah. Carolyn Hennessy, who we love so much. She's coming back. I'm so happy. But, yeah, it's kind of funny that he wiped his hard drive, and then because he knows what to do, and he put it down, and, like, he's being arrested for hacking into the... But that was kind of fast, too, actually. Mm-hmm. It's like, Obrecht finds out this. I mean, it's just like, they're just like, bam, 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 bam.
I knew it was going to be too good to be true for Spinelli to get everything figured out right then and there. That's why I felt like when they arrested him, I was like, okay, so now my eyes are on little Jake.
We'll talk about him later.
Okay.
I have an accompanying picture to go with that. So we're going to talk about little Jake. It's kind of crazy. And as I was looking at, when we seen that, people... Oh, Cheryl Hawks, like, Lacretia and I usually don't agree, but she is spot on with this list of friends. That's so funny. And as someone else was like, someone's agreeing with Ladine. Veronica Vera's agreeing with you so far. But somebody, J. Sam Morgan's like, I don't like Jake, though. He's a dud. What a loser. I want him and Sam to find their way back and Sam to get Jason's better qualities out to bring him out more.
Listen, I never really thought about his name. Jake Doe. Come on, you know it's...
I know.
Like, come on, really?
Like, could you just, like, what is Elizabeth's last name going to be?
Yeah. Just say John Doe.
Yes, I know.
Oh, my God.
It's like, if they were ever to get married, you know, we all know it's not going to happen. It's like, is Elizabeth's last name going to be Doe? I mean, like, seriously. And they apply, I mean, they're gearing up for this wedding. They have a date. What do you put on the marriage license?
I know. That's so crazy.
Morgan.
Oh, my God. You guys in the chat room are talking about Jake Ray. I can't talk about it. Yeah, I'm going to get there in a second. Because you guys are making some good comments. Someone would step for Jake.
Exactly. So much.
Yeah. I was like, okay, but we will talk about it. Like, we will talk about it. But no, I agree with you, R. Mellon fan. Actually, Spinelli's arrest was kind of ridiculous.
Yeah.
We know it's plot driven, obviously.
I just want to know how they found out it was him.
Yeah, because he's a master hacker.
Come on.
He's a jackal.
He's never been caught.
No. And that's what you're saying, right? It's like,
It's like Spinelli never goes to jail. But I guess it was to kind of bring Diane in and just throw a wrench. I mean, it's more plot driven. Yeah. But to me, I feel bad because he's a dad now.
I know.
And he even was showing those revelations, like, oh, yeah. No, I'm a dad. I got to watch what I do.
Yes, I love it. So that means, just again, we're building towards November 6th. So just everybody remember that, Ladine. We're getting there. We're getting there. It's only like a week and a half away. We're getting there. So we're going to get there, girl.
Oh, and someone did answer you about Lexi Ainsworth. Yes. They are saying she is recurring. So thank you, Amanda Pinnell. I hope I said your name right.
Okay, good. So she's recurring. So that's interesting. So, I mean, they need to bring her on more. She's a great actress. Come on. Okay, so the next one. This one is also one of my favorite storylines this week. Anna's breakdown and discovery. Anna, Finola Hughes, just, I mean, she could read the phone book.
I was like, she better act that scene.
No. Oh, my God, she did. Oh, my God.
I was like, I love her now.
Oh, you love her? Okay.
That scene did it for me. I was like, she really went in.
They brought back John Lindstrom.
Yes. Kevin Collins, please.
Yes. Great actor. Oh, yes. But as you said, you're going to say something that's like just the Anna thing.
Oh, yeah. I'm so excited by having Kevin Collins back in the mix. And finally, I have him doing something that's not going to be related about Lucy. Like that. There's so many great storylines for him to get involved with, and that stuff between him and Anna was just fantastic.
It was. Yeah,
that was a scene from like the 90s. It was that good. Like Anna haunted talking to Kevin, and Kevin saying, "Well, you know, it's at my discretion." You know, kind of opening the door because he figured she had broken the law.
Yeah, he did figure that out. And but to her speech about how she was supposed to be good, but she was also in WSB. I mean, like she is a character. She kind of said things that we as fans know about her out loud. It's kind of like, I mean, she's a flawed character, but she's a good character. She's supposed to be one of the good guys, basically.
Right. Well, and to me, it's so much more interesting to see characters like Anna that are more of a gray character. Like, they've done things, and, you know, and they're overall good, but, you know, every once in a while, they got to get down and dirty.
Yeah.
I agree.
And just her performance was just like, and it was a nice, long performance. It was like they gave her some really meaty material. And then at the end, towards the end of the week, when she actually started putting things together, she's like, okay, I'm going to see what Carlos's body looks like.
I like the cat and mouse game that's going on between her and Paul. I'm really curious to see where that's
going
to go.
I see chemistry there, too, of course. I see a little something going on there.
I see it.
Anna and Paul. Ava and Paul. Paul is great with the ladies.
I see it. But, yeah, there's a whole cat and mouse thing going on there, which is good for her. That's her character. That's what she would do. And then also, when she went down there, and her and Jordan have a friendship, which I love seeing they have a friendship. Two women as friends. On a soap.
I know, it hardly ever happens.
And they're not fighting over a man. I mean, like, they're like, you know, cause like Lulu and Maxie had problems for a while there with kind of stuff like that. But, like, this is something totally separate. They became friends through that whole, were undercover, and they, like, kind of helped each other out. And it was kind of like, so, okay, I'll break the rules and stuff. Okay, that's fine, I'll work this out. You know, like, she worked it out for her. And there's no body.
Yeah.
Nothing
in
morgue.
Know what Look at Paul that. Has cooking up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This week he took, like, the back burner.
He did.
But it's for a reason.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I think next week he's about to.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah,
I don't know.
We'll unleash the hounds, right?
So do we think is Carlos dead? Then I mean, they said he cremated his body, but is he dead?
I don't think it was Carlos's body. I think it was Sloane's body.
And so he just said it was a body and cremated it.
Because she read in the files, it said he was shot 2 times. I shot him 4 times.
Yeah, because she even corrected, and that's why she's going insane, because she's like, what is going on here? And I like that, because she, you know, at first is like, how can that report be right? But yeah, and I think, you know, nobody questions an ID when it's attached to somebody, even though they are clearly different ethnicities, guys.
Once they said the body was cremated, I said that wasn't him.
Right.
Well, I knew already.
Even without the bullets, she should know, because she's been gone. She was gone for quite a while before killing Carlos, and she was off in Ireland, go visiting, spreading Duke's ashes. Before she came back, and it's only been 2 weeks, supposedly, since his body's gone. Come on, Anna. You could know that it's like Carlos. It's not. Come on, Anna.
I think she got it. I think there's something. I mean, we didn't get it. We ran out of time, obviously, but I think there's something. Yeah. Mm-hmm. There's something going on there. But yeah, so I was like, okay. And then Sabrina has the ashes, of course, and this whole, I'm doing it for the family, for the parents, and I don't think it's Carlos. I just don't think it is.
Yeah, I'm thinking there's a possibility that Carlos could still be alive, especially with that, you know, baby Sabrina's carrying.
Okay, what do we feel about that? Because I saw online, I seen it here even online.
Yeah.
The dumbest.
Like the timeline.
Story.
Well, she's looked pretty pregnant for a while. Yeah, and I think that's probably why they had her take so many tests and kind of gear it up. Because, yes, he did die about, 6 months ago, I'm thinking?
Yeah.
And yet, we're just now getting her, you know, taking the test. But I kind of think they alluded to the fact that this wasn't the first time.
His story, which is like, wasn't Carlos killed in May? So we can just start going backwards, even if they had... I'm like thinking, oh, she should be more pregnant then. I mean, if anything. I mean...
I just hate the fact that they're trying to say that he may be the father.
Right.
That's something that I just don't like. If you're going to make Michael the father, I'm liking that little storyline between those two. But
so what's up that now, actually? Because I have Michael and Sabrina a little later. We'll just add that in there.
Okay.
It's funny because I got mad at Michael. He had an attitude with her. Well, saying, well, why do you tell me you're pregnant already? And why? It's like just totally courting her, forgetting that she lost a child. Yeah. She was trying to see, she wasn't sure she was pregnant. She really didn't want to be pregnant. Like, all this stuff was going on for her. And he kind of went off on her at first.
He was so like his sunny daddy.
But I understand. I mean, how would you react though if you were told that somebody like, oh, I know I was pregnant for a couple weeks and I didn't tell you? I mean you're first, you might just fly fanned initially, but then you got to take a second and realize, all right, I got to understand where you're coming from.
Well, he came around a little later, obviously, but just like, I didn't like it. That's all I got to say. I didn't like that. Calm down. She had a hard life. She lost a child.
Yeah, and that was the thing, though, is when Michael, though, like, came around, he was just way too happy for that to be his baby. No one's on soaps. If you're happy that you're having a kid, it's not yours.
Right.
That's how it is. Because then there's no story.
Well, you know, there's folks here, like Lee left Denport Jersey, like, why is Sabrina pregnant? This is dumb. I was like...
Because Teresa Castillo is pregnant
in real life. They decided to write it
really
in.
That's really why.
They didn't want to get huge flowers or purses to put in front of her like used to back in the 80s. Yeah. They have a huge purse. You're like, oh, I got a purse. It's crazy. But yeah, I mean, actually, I agree with Daquan. I think Michael and Sabrina are boring. I don't really. I do too.
I mean,
I'd like them both separately. I don't really care for them together.
Yeah, I think it was just something that was thrown in to get Michael away from Kiki for a while, and Sabrina give her a storyline. So, I mean, there was really not much investment to it anyway.
No, and I would think that if this does not turn out to be Michael's baby and they end up splitting up, I don't see where Sabrina goes in the show. I think that she could be easily written off the show.
Right, because we got some other stuff going on. But
I personally don't think Michael will walk away.
Well, I'm glad he won't.
She has the baby and he's there as the father, and then later on he finds out he's not, I think he's still going to be around. He's going to say, that's my child. You know what I mean? I don't think he's going to leave.
Well, I guess that's interesting because he's already kind of come around with Sonny. But if that hadn't happened, and then that situation happened to Michael, I think you'd have a bigger, better understanding for what Sonny's relationship is towards Michael.
Mm-hmm. Well, they said they love each other. That was another kind of fast thing. Yeah. I love you. I love you too.
Yeah, for a while.
Oh, okay, sure.
Okay.
We don't really see you together that much. Yeah. So you guys didn't have this last week. I'm crazy.
But I'm thinking this is a way to write Sabrina out either temporary or permanently. I'm kind of wondering what's going on here. It's like, okay, if they're going to make it Carlos's kid, how's she going to stay on the show? Or, you know, this may be the thing that if she gets kidnapped or whatever, do the mob brings Michael back to the Quartermaines. Because that was way too quick of a 180 for him not to, you know, go back at some point soon.
I agree. And Cheryl agrees with you. Michael will take the role of father regardless. I mean, I agree. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's noble, so he'll do that. But yes, this whole thing that he mentioned, you know, the Corinto side will love it. Well, you got my grandmother who will love you, so it's fine. I mean, on the Quartermaine side, it's like, this baby would have both sides, obviously, of the family. I want him to be a Quartermaine. I don't want him to be a Corinthos.
I'm Corinthos.
There you go.
Corinthos.
Team Corinthos, Team Quartermaine.
I'm King Quartermaine over here.
Team Quartermaine.
Yeah. Are you?
Well, yeah, because I want to see that side of the... You can't just have it all be Corinthos. You got to have some of the Quartermen. You got to be able to have some kind of counterbalance to all the mob stuff.
Yeah, Sonny has like 50 kids running around. The Quartermaines don't have that many.
I don't see much excitement going on with the Quartermaines right now. I think that's why I'm team Corinthos, because it's like the story is like...
But I think there's so much possibility that lays there in the Quartermaine that they've just let go on the wayside for so many years.
They're a great family. Oh my God, they have so much history and...
It's my sister, but they've also killed off so many of the characters.
Quartermaids,
like Emily, and I mean Georgie was married as a Quartermaid, so that's the thing. I consider
and how's the Corinthos family? Aren't they together?
They are together.
That's what I like about them.
They're not dead. Like
exactly.
Those are my favorite characters. The ones that aren't dead.
but there are folks who are like they like both sides. Oh, Kendra John's like hashtag rest in peace Michael Quartermaine. But there's people who are like saying they like both sides too. They also like where he's the combo. I guess Cheryl likes the combo. I kind of agree. I don't mind a combo either. I mean, it's fine. Have both sides of the fame, but I feel like they're leaning really heavily Corinthos with a light mention of Quartermaine.
But yeah, and to me, it's just like the Quartermaines have been a staple for years that have just dwindled and dwindled because of the mob, whether just because Sonny murders all of them or, you know, whatever. I mean, because, I mean, Diego killed a few. Oh, yeah. I mean, it's, the mob just kills all of them.
They need Monica Quartermaine back. Where is she? Where's Monica Quartermaine?
I don't know.
I feel November 6th, we're going to be seeing a lot of her.
November 6th, kids.
I hope that at the altar when Liz gets left, that's what I'm hoping for, that everybody just does a public slapping. Everybody gets one slap that love Jason. It's like Monica, come up. All right. Next in line, Sam. All right.
It's like that scene in Airplane where they're all just slapping
her. Yeah, exactly.
There we go. See Epiphany there with her club just like cracking it. All right.
People are hashtag never forget with the Quartermaines.
Oh, yeah.
Hashtag Team Q. You guys are funny. We agree. We like all four of us. Well, three of us at least.
I was going to say.
No.
We're Quartermaine people, so we're kind of, it's fine.
Mob princess over here.
Mob princess, I know.
I like the danger.
Everybody needs to come and slap. Hashtag where's Monica, exactly. And we're going to lead into this because this leads into Ladine's mm-hmm. family of soaps. Sonny's breakdown and realization.
I'm going to be 100% honest.
Okay, kids.
Even though I'm always honest.
I know, but yeah, you are.
I'm going to have to say that this week, I wasn't a fan of Sonny that much.
What? Okay, buddy, hold on, kids. This is recorded.
I was just getting a little irritated with, you know, him not wanting help and him wanting to get out. I was just a little bit irritated this week. I was like, all right, Sonny, now you're kind of, you know, making me upset. So just stay there and relax.
Okay.
And let your family do what they need to do so that we can, like, I'm a part of the family.
You're part of the family. You're cousin lady.
So that they can, like, you know, speed up the process on getting you out. But he was really, really irritating me this week.
I like, though, that Patrick stepped in.
Yes.
Right. Yeah, the scene with Patrick was amazing.
He was a man. He was like, I'm going to stay because just Carly, I'll handle this.
Mm-hmm.
He did. He was like, Carly.
I love that. I was like, all right, way to go, Patrick. Yes.
Because Sonny was going off on Patrick. Like, go ahead. Yes, go ahead.
I was just going to say that's why we need more characters like Patrick on the scene that will actually call Sonny out on their crap. And he's not a mobster. He's a doctor. But he has never had a problem just telling Sonny. I remember when Sonny came into his house and fired a gun and Robin was there and Emma. And he was like, no, you get out of my house. Like, Patrick has never, ever once wavered on the mob there. You know, and that's why I'm so sad he's leaving.
Caroline wrote, hashtag Ladine Carithos.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
We're going to start that hashtag. I'm going to continue that hashtag, kids. I'm going to continue it. I wish I had a pen
that
on me.
That sounds so good.
I'm going to totally write
that. Sounds so good.
If I had a pen, I'd write that down right now. But I'm going to start that hashtag. That's right. Because other folks are like, Ladine, what happened to Ladine? That's what Sherlock's like. What happened to Ladine? What has happened to Ladine?
So, Ladine, you decided to be part of the Corinthos clan. Do you do it by marrying Michael or Morgan?
I'll snatch Michael up in a heartbeat.
Okay.
I might fight him for that one.
But then we got folks
I think Michael's adorable.
I know.
Then we got folks like Lucretia, I love you.
I know. I was like, I gotta give
some
love back.
You both are like working it out over here. But Ladine, hashtag Ladine Chris, let's start that one on Twitter. Let's start that. We're gonna work that out. But yeah, people are like, yeah, I love that Patchy just got in there. It was like, okay, come on, man. Let's work this. I can't even. Almost did it. I did do it. Almost cussed. Let's work this S out. Come on, your family's here. Let's do this.
Yeah, he just put him in his place and I was like,
yes. And Sonny's like, So Sonny had a realization, kind of like, okay, I got to get back in bed and just work this out, I guess.
Mm-hmm. The great scene of him, like, I'm going to stand up right now.
We knew it was going to fall. Like, we knew it was going to happen.
I couldn't even watch it. Like, I was like this, watching that scene.
Yes, exactly.
I was like, he's going to fall.
But it was so funny. I mean, that's the thing is, I can't help but laugh. And I know I'm not the only one. I see it all up in the chat here, too. Everybody's laughing at Sonny in the wheelchair.
I know.
We're not terrible people. He's just a TV character.
It's a TV character, exactly. Exactly. We don't advocate anybody. I mean, please.
But now, with off of Sonny's realization, though, I mean, we see that his relationship with Michael for this week there, where he's really being adamant with Michael, do not get involved in the mob. And you can tell Michael
that's
is feeling
too.
Really, I guess, offended that he's not being given a chance to do that, and he's passing it over and giving it to Max instead.
Which I love that idea. And Max, it's great to see Not Jude Cheatwood. It was, I forget which one.
Derek
Cheatwood. I forget which ones they are. But it was glad to see both brothers on. Mm-hmm. It was glad to see Max. Max, I love Max. And I'm so glad to see him. And I miss Max and Diane. But I love seeing him. And he should be in charge right now. And Sonny's going to still feed stuff into him, obviously. But it's going to be, you know, he should be the, he's already in the mob. So
yeah, without Jason and Sean and, you know, all the many people who have fallen, Max has always been there.
Yep, so, that's true. Yeah.
Wait a minute, Milo's hair, though. Milo did not come back with a great hairdo.
Yeah, I was like,
ugh, Epiphany cut that hair or styled it for him before he came.
Totally. And so then we go into Nina Franco Kiki. Not a huge storyline, but he had a fun, some fun moments.
Good Lord, Nina just getting like, oh my gosh, we're going to have friends come over. We're going to have a party. And she's going to introduce her friends.
No.
But it made sense because remember, her brain's in the 20s.
Yes.
I was trying to remind myself that even though she's probably around my age in real life, but she's like in her 20s because she's not coma for 20 years. So she would kind of be like, oh my God, like totally, oh my God. Like, I mean, she's like, it, to me, it was kind of funny because it was like such a different.
Yeah, I actually really like that, and I kind of hope that her and Maxie do become friends, because they do have a lot in common. Yeah. And yeah, it is, like, I think I pointed it out last week as well, that you have to think of Nina as someone in her 20s, even though she looks like she's in her 40s, because she was in the coma, and this is who she is. So it kind of makes the character a little more interesting, and you can actually, you know, root for her now.
Yes, I agree.
Because, you know, she's trying.
Yes.
I would rather have more scenes like this than more scenes of her being gaslighted by Rick about like the size of a baby. Yeah, like enough of the crazy not you weirdo Nina. I'd rather see this one.
Yeah.
And I like her and Kiki had to go back and forth. I'm liking the new Kiki. I'm sorry.
I think Aaron's really made it. Yeah.
I love it. I love she's just bitchy and just like, oh my God. And then she kind of came around. I was like, okay, I'll help you out. I used to be catering.
That's what I like.
Yeah.
I like that those little moments that they put them on one accord and then they'll have them going at it. I like those little moments because then they seem more sincere.
Yes.
You know what I mean? That's what I really like.
That's what, Sure Hawks, I love Nina and Kiki bonding. The other one, Nina, gives me a reason to like Kiki. I agree with that. I mean, I think it's just kind of like now we're tying her into something. Because the Ava stuff's too serious right now. It's all too, and Morgan, it's all crazy. But at least with Franco being a pseudo-father, it's kind of redeeming them, too, a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think it's nice to see Franco and Nina try to be normal people, because forever they were just off on their own, being crazy. Like, they didn't really fit in the cast. But now this is, like, more of, and it makes sense. It's, you know, very character-driven, not so much plot-driven, to really get them in here with Kiki. So I'm really liking that the writers have kind of put this little odd group together. It really gives them something to do and makes them a little more rootable. Because Kiki now make it a job, like we've all been saying for, what, 2 years now?
Yeah. That's like being catering would be really good, actually. In real life, it just happened, it was before I could actually put it in the show today, and so I mentioned in the chat room. In real life, Michelle Stafford just had a baby boy. Do a surrogate. So congratulations to her. I think it was today. She got it or yesterday, last night. Or so she's a new baby. So kind of in real life. So it's kind of fun.
Hey.
Right?
And I enjoyed just the that whole cocktail dinner scene.
Oh my God, it was so weird. That mango martini looked good. I was like, that was good to me.
But just Franco just like immediately just eyeing like, or this is not just like a, hey, we're here, hang out.
Again, fast writing. Yeah. It was like fast.
This is a shakedown. Like this is a shakedown. Yes. What's up?
And I love how Maxie kept moving away from him. Yeah. So I was like, wait a minute. Yeah. Him and Max had this weird history. So they did play that though. They did. She was kind of like, she was getting close to her man. So yeah, I kind of like, and Nathan.
Yeah, I like how she wouldn't take his drink either. She was like, no, thank you.
And I also like Nathan just calling out what it's been going on for the longest time. Franco's just been doing nothing for, professionally for a while and just been kind of just like living on Nina's dime.
Yep. Do you think he's using her?
I don't think he's using her, I generally think that he does love her, but I just feel like, I don't know, he had that crisis of confidence there with his art. And then since then, I mean, he's never really gone back to that at all.
No,
so.
He hasn't.
Yeah, I mean, he was working at the hospital as the art therapist, and that's sort of kind of how he and Nina got involved, I think, initially. And so maybe he can just go back to his job. I think even, like, he may have mentioned that when Nathan was pointing it out. Because, Dr. O loves Franco. She'll give him his job back.
Yeah, she would.
And, I don't think he's using Nina, because that's never, you know, I get Nathan being concerned, and that actually made his character a little more likable. Mm-hmm. But, I think Franco, it gave him the realization, I haven't been working.
Yeah, and so speaking of that, we'll go into Maxie Lulu Dante comics. It wasn't a big storyline this week either, but the part that bugged the crap out of me, because we work in Hollywood and many of us work in different projects, how do you break a contract and go, I got to set up for a Halloween party when I have a contract with you to October 30th?
Yes. That was ridiculous.
I'm like, you could have made a different conflict, but it was like, That was a most ridiculous setup. I mean, as an event planner for 20 years, that made no sense.
Well, and she was just huffing and puffing around with the, like, I thought it was cute how it started out with Maxie, and then it was just, and then she's huffing and puffing, and I'm like, Lulu, chill.
And,
right.
And that wire orange cat.
Yes, yeah. Moving around, moving around. But I'm like, so, okay, so now I got to crowdsource on philanthropy, whatever.com. I got to crowdsource, and Lulu's just like, okay, whatever. I'm like, this makes no sense. I mean, I like all of them together and all the mixing up and stuff, but this part of storyline this week bugged the crap out of me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was just pushing stuff to unrealistic events to make something happen that you want to have happen story-wise.
Exactly. It didn't work for me.
Which, you know, when they brought up during that scene, oh, we can show a clip of the movie.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. We know it's going to happen next week.
Oh, okay. All right. They're setting it up. Let's see what you guys have going on this week.
They're setting it up.
I think that's what we were saying last week. It's like, you know there's going to be a party where they show the video.
Yes. I know. Like, oh, okay. That'd be horrible. And then we had a bit piece of Brad and Lucas.
I know, finally. And I loved that Brad went to Alexis and was like, hey, soon to be mother, whatever we are, you know, brought it up. And,
but again, enough dragging it out, Brad. Just tell us already what the deal is.
Yeah, what did you do?
He's not that important to be dragging out stories.
Right, he said all he could tell us was that I could go to prison if I divorce her. So I'm like, what? What does that mean? I mean, my parents are the least of my problems. Like, what does that mean?
Yeah, that's why I felt like the new writer's kind of disappointed me on that, because that thing's been dragging on for so long that if you're going to bring that up again, then follow through and start something rolling.
I know. But I'll tell you, I did like Julian and Lucas, because their relationship has always been very realistic to me, because he kind of goes, you were a homophobe, and now all of a sudden you're fighting for me. It's like, it was a great natural progression between, they talk like men, just like two dudes, and because Lucas is kind of a dude, I mean, they kind of talk that way, and I love it. I just think it showed a great evolution. They actually really care about each other.
Yeah, I really like that. And Lucas has been the one when Julian was in jail. So, you know, because Sam's obviously got so much else going on. So it's nice to see, like, the Lucas and Julian relationship. Because, it's not stepping. I mean, Lucas always says, it's not stepping on my love for Tony. I mean, he was my dad and all that matters, but you're here now. So I'm trying to build a relationship. And, you know, I just wish we could see more. I mean, Brad and Lucas are, you know, interesting.
Well, here's the thing. Here's my quick little rant, everyone, because I've seen it online, too. They always want to know what I'm thinking. My little rant about daytime television, because on Days of Our Lives, we just had a huge, there's a controversy that happened with their gay character's storyline, and they killed one of the major characters off who was gay. And so with this storyline, it's like the same time, all of a sudden, Brad and Lucas were not forefront anymore. And I just feel like these are characters, they wrote them like regular people who happened to be gay. And so Brad was a fully formed character on the show. No side character, but he's a fully formed character. Mm-hmm. Lucas is a legacy character. He comes from, you know, all these big families and everything. He was a doctor and all that. I'm like, you can write a great story. They both have chemistry. It's a great story. I'm like, don't chicken out. GH writers, please continue the storyline. Please. Let's see a wedding. Please let it happen.
Yeah, and that's the thing. It's like, we're gearing up for Sam and Patrick's and Jake's and Liz. And it's like, Brad and Lucas have been gay since the nurse's ball, guys. Like, why don't we get theirs first? Let's see it on GH Writers. I mean, we all want to see more Brad and Lucas. Yes. I have never heard anybody say anything different.
Me either.
And we got it all on here, too.
Yeah, on here, too, same thing.
Well, I'm hoping with Patrick, unfortunately, leaving the show, that's going to create room for Lucas to kind of step up and be more of a prominent role in the hospital.
That's very true.
I think that would be good.
That is true. And then my last one, I have a picture with this one. I keep finding these pictures of him. The actor, James Nyber, is great. The kid actor is so good. He's so creepy. Oh my God, those scenes at the Halloween. Poor Cameron.
No, I know. And he's all, oh, I scared him.
I just scared him. He's been gone for a long time. I'll go upstairs. Look at him. He is creepy. He is so creepy. And then he's like telling Jake, you're my daddy. Like, you're really my daddy.
I was like, whoa.
I'm like, will he be the one to tell? I mean,
that's what I'm going to say. It seems like he's going to be the one to spill it before Spinelli and them find out.
Or Laura, anybody.
Well, but then Laura also, just like, hey, talking to Liz, like, maybe you should just get him checked out. Just check
well,
out.
Well, no, Laura's like, I'm not a pushover, don't worry.
That was like one of my favorite lines. I told you, I was like, is this your quote?
These boys are all, you know, that was going to be one of my best. Since he was like, I'm not a pushover, I was like, ooh, go on, girl. That's right.
Oh, and side note, if we're bringing up Laura real quickly, just the frostiness between him, her, and Nicholas.
Ooh, I know.
Right there.
He was like, what's going on? Nothing.
Yeah, I love that scene.
Mother, do you want, I'm fine.
It's like Laura, Lulu, and Nicholas. That was finally like Lulu is getting more and more Spencer like. As long as she doesn't say the word baby, I'm cool.
Oh
like,
my god!
It's sort of like, it's
well,
like,
she said it this week too.
I know, but it was like that scene's so great with the three of them. She was very Spencer there. Yes.
Hashtag demon seed eyes. I love that. Hashtag Brucus wedding. So they got to get in there. So
Stepford Jake. Oh, that's another hashtag.
Let's think of Jake. It's like, oh my god. But yeah, he's like, that child is nowhere near creep. I can't understand. After I can't understand what you're saying, I was going to read it, but I can't understand what that sentence means. But I just think he's a great actor. He's a great little actor. And it's like, it's just kind of funny. Like, we're showing more about him. So I think he's going to be prominently in the story too. November 6th, kids. November 6th. Lady, November 6th.
I feel like when Halloween comes, he's just going to slide on that clown mask and then just walk around that house. He's going to be stabbing people left and right.
I can see him on a little tricycle at the end of the hall.
Okay. So now we're going to that was a recap of GH. I hope we caught everything. I think we did. Again, the writing was really fast, and so we're just going to see what happens. This week is the week before the week of the reveals and of the wedding and stuff, so it should be very interesting. But we're going to go into our segments, and first, of course, we have Frank with Get Him to the ER Stats.
Now, usually with the Get Him to the ER Stat, it's usually a character, but this week I felt like it was storylines that I am just getting tired of, and I feel like we're getting to the point now with the new writers, I think that some of this is going to be taken care of sooner rather than later. And then one was already changed a little bit. It was certainly Olivia and Julianne's baby issue there with baby Lee. And I felt like that was kind of addressed in a way that wasn't cliche. And my issue with the storylines this week is like you're doing a lot of the cliche stuff, especially with Lulu and the baby talk.
Yes.
Please stop doing the storyline where we don't need to have Lulu saying the word baby and we're going to have a baby. And our love is so great. And the baby. And I can't believe our love was jeopardized. Please. This storyline is killing me.
Same here. Same here. Is this 1955? I'm like, all of a sudden my baby's going to save everything.
It's like, Lulu, you run a casino boat. You have all these other things. Get off babies for a bit. Rocco's, what, like 2, 3? I don't know how old he is in soap years, but.
It's just, I want them to do something. And I know that come Halloween, it seems like something's going to happen.
Yeah.
But whatever that is, it's got to be an improvement over where it is now.
Yeah.
So please get this storyline fixed there. Yes. And the next one is also just Sonny in the wheelchair. Please, I know about this guy. Like, I don't need this chair. I don't need this chair. Get me home. Enough of this. That cliche thing of the guy that just refused to listen to any sort of medical advice and thinks he knows better. He's a mobster. You're not a doctor, but I know better.
Right.
That storyline is very cliche as well, where you're refusing to listen to medical advice.
Yeah, of course. It's like,
so, like, laughable, guys.
Yes. Well, that was game. Let's get those people to the ER stat, please. And then, of course, we have our lovely lady with the love in the afternoon.
Love in the afternoon. This week was a little bit hard to find something that I actually, like, loved or could put in that category. But what I'm going to say that kind of just touched me just a little bit is still that hint of friendship between Dylan and Lulu, even though he kissed her.
Yeah.
I like that they didn't completely separate them. Oh, the friendship is over. They still have communication when they come into the room, even though you can still sense that tension.
Because
I know that if I had a guy friend that kissed me, I probably would not even deal with him anymore. But I like where the writer's going with their friendship.
They have a long history.
Right, so that's why I like the fact that even though they put that in there, they still are finding ways around it. That's what I really like this week.
Technically, I mean, they were brother and sister. I mean, step. But they both love Tracy. The fact that they wouldn't just not be talking over that just would be, blasphemous.
Mm-hmm.
And, I'd like to clear up. I love Robert Palmer
Watkins.
That's
right, she does,
and
everybody.
Dylan is, like, my favorite character right now because he's certainly the cute one that I'm always cheering for. So I don't know why, something got misconstrued last week, but I love Dylan.
She does, and we all do. And the thing is, and he's excited to come on the show. I've talked to him since, and he's so excited to come on the show. And we're really really happy. That's in 2 weeks. That's on November 8th, and we'll give you more details when that happens. But yeah, she likes him. We all like him.
We all love Dylan. We've
accepted him. We've accepted him.
I've missed, though, it's been the longest time since we've had a Tracy Lulu scene. Just the two of them really talking stuff together. And I feel like, where is that? I don't want Sabrina and Tracy.
Same here.
Lulu can easily fill those roles.
As someone actually asks, where's Aunt Bobby? Because she's on the show. She's reoccurring. Where's Aunt Bobby?
Yeah, she was at the lame wedding last week. But where was she this week?
Yes, exactly. Well,
I really think.
I thought, Ladine, you were going to pick Sunny in the wheelchair as your loving
Not this week.
Not this week.
Or the billionth time Julie and Alexis had sex on something new.
Yes.
No.
No, not this time. And
this time.
So now we got our winner, and we always love to hear these, the winner and loser of the week from Miss Lacretia.
Well, definitely my winner this week has to go to Alexis. I mean, I was actually glad that not only did she have some scenes where she wasn't having sex with Julian, like the scene with Brad, that was great.
Yes.
It was just how she was so understanding with the Olivia situation and didn't try to hide it. She just, like, immediately, as soon as she read those results, was like, hey, Julian. And then she's like, but I understand where she's coming from. You need to chill. Give her some space. She's the mom. It's like, go, Alexis.
No, I felt like it was like certainly those kind of scenes and those kind of characters, usually somebody's trying to get the truth for some sort of reason. They're trying to either, you know, accomplish something that they want. But it felt like Alexis just wanted the truth out and didn't have any sort of a malicious intent, but just wanted everybody to know just the truth. And let's just all proceed accordingly, that in the best possible way.
Yeah, and that was so unsoapy to me. They didn't drag it out. She was just really trying to do the right thing. It's like, whoa. And then I guess my loser, I know because it was requested last week, and like I say, it's pretty hard to put her in every week. We got to flip it up. But Liz, because I'm sorry, whenever...
I was like, all right, don't put Sunny there.
I thought this week.
Yeah,
well, Sunny can't stand up for himself, because I'm sorry, the scene where she just blasé'd over Laura's like, hey, you need to get this kid checked out.
Yes.
And then you also had when she asked Patrick to stand up for her with all of what she's been doing. It's like, uh-uh. Yes. You are pathetic, Liz. Don't worry. I love the story.
Yeah, no, we love the story. Yeah. And then somebody on here, Boob 69 Bees. Mm-hmm. Elizabeth will always be loser of the week. That's right, kids. Poor thing. Someone goes, Elizabeth always wins with me. For me, I love her. Loser Liz. They agree with you on that one.
I think we can pretty much, as we talked a little bit last week, we can black out the most of November for Liz.
Yeah.
Definitely.
These next 2 weeks or so, it's going to be happening.
I know. It's like, like I said, I wanted to put Sunny, but don't kick a man when he's down.
No, he don't. So that's funny.
Give me a high five for that one.
Okay, so now it's time for my quote of the week. And actually, I have three quotes this week because I have one. Well, I did kind of have one last week, but I wasn't here. But I couldn't choose her three lines that I just really enjoyed. And they're all quick, so I'm going to do three of them. One is this new character, Darby Collette, who asked out Morgan. And when she was talking, she's like, because we're talking about Kiki being over there, it's all crazy. It's like, you're like an M. Night Shyamalan movie. You know it's going to end badly, but you can't look away.
I loved that.
I love it, because half his movies I hate. And then Brad to Alexis, when she was like trying to get the office stuff, goes, and Brad goes, the baby pacifier will work. I can't believe you snatched some kid's binky. She's like, it was left on the counter. And then, and this is the line that is really profound that I got from Anna. And Anna to Sabrina, and she said, the worst among us are capable of good, and even the best among us are capable of harm. Ooh. That's a very profound statement.
It is deep.
I just thought that was a great... She's talking about herself, basically.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And Carlos, because you're talking about Carlos, it's like, but she's also saying herself.
Right.
And that was a very profound statement. And we did, okay, you guys on online, we both did like the I'm No Pushover. We did like that line too. But I wanted to find a couple others that were really, really good. And so now we have some news and gossip. And I have a couple of items. And then we got some pictures to go with these. So, because November 6th, lady, November 6th. Welcome back, Audrey! Graham is coming back. Rachel Ames is coming back. She's actually she's not from the very, very, very beginning, but she's close. She's one of the longest running, earliest cast members to be on the show. And she's coming back for October 30th.
Does she give her shrug of disapproval?
Well, probably that too. But she's giving a gift to Elizabeth, apparently. But I'm like, I welcome her back. That's great. I did not know she was coming back. I thought she was retired and not really doing anything. So it'll be good to see her and a piece of history, because she also told Graham, so I think we're carrying them boys or whatever. And so that's a good one. Dr. Drake is actually leaving. It's been announced.
Yeah.
Looks like after the wedding, sometime after the wedding, Jason Thompson is out of Port Charles. And they're saying there's rumors he might be headed to Y&R.
I hope so, because I watched that one, too. And we, you know, there's rumors that we might be losing the only doctor on the show. So
there you go.
Dr. Drake, just go on over there.
The rumor is that he's not really happy with the GH storylines. That's the rumor. So we don't know. So he could always come back. But there's a whole other rumor going on that him and Kimberly McCullough will be leaving together. Her character, Robin, is going to come back and usher them out. Has not been confirmed, but that's the rumor we heard, that they're going to leave together. But then, of course, everybody's like, what's going to happen to little Brooklyn Sizer, who plays Emma Grace?
Right. Now, mm-hmm. Would you be mad if Patrick was recast?
That's a good question.
I really wouldn't want him to be recast, because I don't see the point. I mean, yes, if the storyline wasn't over, that would be fine, but I think that writing him out with Robin would be the best solution. And because to me, they're a little family unit. I just wouldn't want to see anybody else in it.
It's too much.
Interesting. Yeah. Interesting.
No, I know certainly a lot of people respond to Emma being such a great actress.
Yes, she's such a great actress for Brooklyn.
Yeah, they'd like to keep her on the show, and I feel like the only way you could really do that is if you recast Patrick in some fashion.
Well, what about Anna? I mean, she can always come visit Grandma.
Yeah.
Well, there's a rumor they want to star as her, which is, of course, is the soap opera Rapid Aging Syndrome. I hope they don't do that, because the actress is... Yeah. I was hoping the actress would be like Kimberly McCullough and grow up on the show.
Well, I still think because, you know, Spencer and Cameron, they're still that same age too. I mean, unless they accelerated their ages, which I don't think that they're... I mean, Spencer seems to be sort of...
Yeah, he's adorable.
The fans of her are like, no, we cast Patrick. They just want her and Robin, him and Robin to go off in the sunset.
Well, yeah. I mean, and Robin stayed on the show even when her parents left. Yeah. I mean, and like I say, I mean, it can be recurring just like with Anna. I mean, she still does have family on there.
She could live with Anna.
Yeah.
You can think of grandma. People read grandma's raised children all the time. And I mean, that's nothing. Yeah, there's nothing. There's a whole culture about that. I mean, that's nothing, you know, out of the ordinary. So, and people are saying, stay with Anna or Mac. Or Mac. Hello.
No, that's true. You raised Mac and Anna?
Yes. Hello. I forgot about that. That's right.
Yeah. And
Well, what they also heard, too, is that Billy Miller's going to be leaving the show for a while, too, because he's going to be doing the Urban Cowboy pilot.
Yes. Right. Yes.
So he's going to be gone, and they want to figure out exactly if that's going to time the same time, maybe after the revelation that he's Jason Quartermaine / Morgan, that he's going to take off for a while to go try to find himself.
Yeah.
So, November 6th. Is going to destroy everyone.
It's November 6th.
It's sending everyone into hiding place.
That's right.
Everyone, nobody's safe.
Safe. And then there was a real life split of two people. Chad Duell and Kristen Alderson actually have split up. They've been together for several years. Of course, she played the original Kiki on the show, and she was star manning on Life to Live and on General Hospital. She actually wrote on her Twitter that she's leaving Los Angeles and going back to New York or something. And she actually wrote, it seemed like it was goodbye, L.A., into a new chapter in my life. I will always love you. And she, at his Twitter, which is Dooley87, thank you for always being my best friend. That's what she wrote. So that's kind of nice,
well,
I guess.
That's nice.
That's very nice. But they're actually splitting up, and hopefully she'll show up on something, because I like her. Hopefully she'll show up on something.
Well, there's that article that she did in Soaps and Death, where she just talked about that after she left the show, that trying to do other projects that she really wanted. I mean, she was getting instructed to go back and take acting classes, because, you know, the audition process, even though she's worked on soaps for so long, the audition process, she hasn't really done that.
I guess not. She hasn't, right? I guess she hasn't. She's one of those who grew up on a show, on Why to Live.
Yeah.
They're like, this is crazy. So, yeah, so that's kind of sad for them. And then here's something that's interesting. There's apparently a new doctor coming to town, and it's a new psychiatrist.
Oh.
So I don't think so. I think a picture of him up there, too. His name is Anthony Montgomery. As Andre Maddox. There he is up there. And he's kind of hunky.
I was like, I would rather have Kevin because he's a legacy character.
Okay, that's fine.
I need my glasses.
But he makes his debut November 6th. Everything's happening on the 6th. And we'll handle Anna's case. So hopefully he's a great actor and we'll actually see him, because she's a great actress, of course. And some people are also wondering if he's going to help Morgan with his bipolar thing, because they kind of dropped that storyline all of a sudden.
That disappoints me tremendously.
Me too.
Because you've got Kevin Collins right there.
Yes, I know.
Like Lucretia was saying, why would you write that? Give him, make him just the new Patrick Drake. Make him just a surgeon or something like that. Why? I mean, you've got a great psychiatrist that you're not using enough as it is.
Yes.
I know.
So it'll be interesting.
Frustrating.
So he's a new doctor coming in. But Kevin can always come on too. I mean, everybody's crazy there. They all could use some psychiatry.
Yeah, but come on. After seeing this week, with John Lindstrom,
I agree.
Vanilla Hughes.
Yeah. Like, that scene was perfect. Stormy, I want to see John and Roger together.
I know. That'd be good together, too. But yeah, a lot of people in this town need to shrink somebody. So, like I said, so there's, room for, there's enough shrinks for everybody. And then, of course, this is great news for us because we do the after show. Because as long as General Hospital's on the air, we're on the air. And the ratings are up. So the ratings are up. There's certain, if you guys don't know this, there's certain rating demographics they really look for, and it's up in all households. It's also up in the advertisers that are women 18 to 49 and 18 to 34, totally up. And it's so happy. Mm-hmm. It's a third of all four of the fourth soaps, but it's also gone up about a few hundred thousand or so. So it's like at 2.6 million a week.
And it's so coincidentally, that's all happened since the GH report started.
Yeah, I think so.
So I mean, so. I don't know what that.
I don't know. I mean, I think so. I think so. I think there's a correlation there somewhere.
I think so.
Yep. I don't doubt that at all. But we're very happy. Congratulations, GH, and all the viewers that watch them, because, like I said, if they're not on the air, we're not on the air. So, and they're in their 52nd year, 53rd year. So it's good. This is a great thing. And it's the only soap on ABC.
I know.
Besides nighttime soaps, of course. But it's the only soap that's on daytime. And so we're glad they'll hold on as long as they can. So we're going to do some predictions before we end. And here we go. Love it.
And now, your AfterBuzz TV predictions.
Okay, do you have any predictions, kids?
Well, I love Lucretia's. I didn't even think about it. It's like, we're thinking about where Paul got this body from, but realizing that it would be Sloan, that would be the body for that.
Hello. I forgot about him.
Yep, just because when the report said 2 weeks ago, just two shots, that's what happened to Sloan. Yeah. So. Makes sense.
Sloan and Carlos, I mean, they look pretty identical, guys.
Yeah, I know. I was like, they're clearly two different ethnicities. So, you're really going to have to say that Emmy fudged that report for us to believe it.
I would love, okay, I'm just gonna lie. I'd love Britt to come back and come back for Brad and Lucas's way. She'd be the person of honor. That's what she should be. She'd be the woman of honor, I guess, in the wedding for Brad, standing up for Brad.
Yeah, I would love that too, because I love Brit. I'm just so sad she's not on there.
I'm sad she's not on it. She's not on anything right now.
Mm. Well, I feel like with Brad's revelation, whatever secret is, that, I mean, the writers aren't going to waste that opportunity to tie it into the larger GH canvas in some fashion. Because if it's just some kind of one-off where it doesn't really impact anything.
Yeah.
So I figure it's got to impact somebody or something else there on the GH canvas. I don't know what it is, but I feel like that revelation is going to play into the larger part of the show.
I predict.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I'm going to look right into the camera.
Tell him.
I predict that on November 6th, Sonny will have some feeling in his leg.
Okay.
Some type of feeling somewhere in the legs.
Okay, so we're predicting that he's not going to be.
He's not going to be there much longer. No.
He's going to hear that that Jake is really Jason, and all of a sudden you see his toes start to twitch. Jason!
Well, you know, they were like brothers. They were the other bromance. They were the bromance. I
can't wait for that.
Healed my spine, Jason.
Oh my God, that's so funny.
See, this is why I'd love for Rick and AJ to come back and just be like, God, guys, why don't y'all just get married like Brad and Lucas over there?
We're
real brothers.
Yeah, where's Rick? Like, where's Rick?
I know. He needs to come back and give Jordan a storyline, a little romance.
I know.
That would be interesting. Rick and Jordan.
Mm-hmm. I'm a big fan of Jordan, so I want her to be more.
More Jordan.
My prediction is that Anna is going to actually, with I guess this new shrink, I guess, admit that she killed Carlos.
She's so close.
Unless she's going to, because it's eating her alive. Mm-hmm. Her being dependent on the drugs, she's going to be dependent on the drugs. She's just so distraught. It was crazy.
But I'm going to see every one of the scenes. I'm going to think, like, this would be 10 times better if Kevin Collins was in this.
I know.
Need more Kevin Collins. John Lindstrom, I know, is busy in prime time, but. Yeah. We've got plenty of time, bud.
Yeah, come on in. Come on in.
Yeah.
Do a few scenes. So.
And I love how someone, Ethel, has said, no, Sonny will walk on Christmas for the Christmas miracle. I like your prediction.
I can see that, too, actually. Let me just, they go, Rick and Jordan would be great together. People are like, okay, I can see that, actually, too. I can see close up in the air. I
can see that. Because it's closer on, like, Thanksgiving or Christmas time. They usually do, like, that one kind of, like, throw-off episode.
They do, yes.
Where I can imagine it is Sonny having something where all of a sudden he can stand up out of the chair and walk around and see stuff.
Yes.
That's already got my loser of the week.
Already. You're not even there yet. It's crazy. And so that was the week that was here on AfterBuzz TV's GH Report. Thank you for tuning in with us and commenting. You guys are great on here. And continue the conversation on our GH page or on Twitter. You can tune it with, the hashtag ABTVGHReport or GH Report, or tag one of us in there, and we'll continue the conversation with you. Frank, where can I find you?
You can find me on Twitter at HappyGoJackie, and you can see me, if you like it, Wednesday at 8 o'clock at the Comedy Central Theater doing an improv show for an hour with my team Max.
You can find me on Twitter at Ladine_Harvey, hashtag Ladine Corinthos.
Yes, like Ladine Corinthos. We're going to do it. We're going to work it.
And you can find me all over the web at Lacretia Lyon, and that is LacretiaLyon. And also on Halloween night, I'll be at the Comedy Store for Scary Bitka, since I can say that on the air. And it starts at 7:30 or 8 o'clock.
Oh, I love it. And of course, you can find me on all the interwebs. Just type in James Lott Jr. or Black Hope LA, you can find me. But specifically, this Wednesday, I do the Mysteries of Laura after show, and we're doing two episodes in one. That's on Wednesday at 7:30, and then my radio show every Friday morning on AdrenalineRadio.com, the Super Organized Universe Radio at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Thank you for watching us. We love you guys, and we'll see you next week.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
From executive producers Maria Menounos,
the views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.